This recipe is not for everyone. It's for people living the alkaline lifestyle. Hello, and welcome to another episode. My name is Manny, and this is Grubbany. And today, I'll be showing you how to make a delicious alkaline vegan butternut squash bread. Let's get started. For this recipe, we're going to be using 4 cups of white spelt flour. White spelt flour is different from spelt flour because it doesn't contain the outer germ or bran. This is one of my go-to alkaline flours for baking. Add 4 cups of white spelt flour to a large bowl. You can also use a mixture of spelt and kamut flour or spelt and rye flour. Add 1/4 teaspoon of sea salt. Add 1 cup of date sugar. Add 1/2 tablespoon of ginger powder for that holiday aroma. Add 1/4 teaspoon of Ceylon cinnamon. This is highly optional. Finally, add 1/4 teaspoon of ground cloves. Now we're going to give it a really good mix. Set this aside after mixing while we prep our wet ingredients. We're going to be making a butternut squash puree. Over here, I have 2 cups of roasted, unsalted butternut squash. If you don't know how to roast butternut squash, click on the link above. Add 2 cups of roasted, unsalted butternut squash to your food processor. Next, add 1/2 cup of agave nectar. Add 1/2 cup of walnut milk. Now, if you don't know how to make walnut milk, click on the link above to watch a quick and easy recipe. Now we're going to add 2 huge tablespoons of organic applesauce. Add 4 tablespoons of grapeseed oil. This will keep the bread extra moist. I like to leave little bits of butternut squash in my puree. Next, add 1.5 cups of sparkling spring water to your dry ingredients. Add your butternut squash puree. Now we're going to give it a good mix. You could use a spatula, a mixer, or even your hand. Fun fact, I have a brand new mixer I haven't used in 7 years. Can you imagine? I really need to start using it. Anyway, this is how thick your batter should be. Grease a 9x5 loaf pan with some grapeseed oil. The dough is extremely sticky and the bread is extremely dense, so you want to make sure you properly grease the pan. Add your dough to the greased pan, spread it out, then give it a few taps on your countertop and a few shakes to release trapped air. Wipe down your loaf pan with a paper towel, then bake at 350 degrees Fahrenheit for 1 hour 15 minutes to 1 hour 30 minutes. If you have any leftover dough, bake them in ramekins. Just be sure to grease your ramekins with some grapeseed oil before adding the dough. Bake at 350 degrees Fahrenheit for 1 hour or until done. To know if it's done, insert a toothpick. If it comes out clean or with some butternut squash residue, it's done. Separate it from the ramekin using a butter knife. Ideally, you need to wait for it to cool down before you even touch it. But this is 3 a.m. and I need to go to sleep. Anyway, this is what it looks like. It's really moist, soft, and bouncy. Now for the loaf, insert a toothpick, and if it comes out clean or with some residue of butternut squash, you're good to go. The outside of the bread is quite dry as expected, but the inside is extremely moist and this bread is dense. Separate the loaf from the loaf pan using a butter knife. You should wait for it to cool down before slicing, but as I mentioned, it's 3 a.m. and I don't have time for that. Here you go. This bread goes really well with a spread of my tahini butter. If you've made this recipe and you have some in the freezer, leave it out to rest at room temperature, and when it melts, you're good to go. If you haven't made this recipe, click on the link above. All you have to do is stop short of filling the muffin liners and you have yourself a really good tahini spread. Anyway, thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe and don't forget to tune in next week for another delicious recipe. I'll see you all next week.